This is the introduction to Apache Kafka on brokers. Now, we've talked about events, topics, and partitions, but I have not formally introduced you to the actual computers that are doing the work here. From a physical infrastructure standpoint, Kafka is composed of a network of machines called brokers, each one of them running the Kafka server process. If you go and download an Apache Kafka tarball and uncompress it, you'll have a script that will spin up this JVM process that will be Kafka. Or you can do that in Docker. You can get a standard Docker image, set that up at Docker Compose, have a group of them that can all see each other, and those are Kafka brokers. So they can be physical servers that you can see with blinky lights in your infrastructure. They can be instances in the cloud. They can be Raspberry Pi compute modules. You have options here. What matters is that historically, brokers have access to local storage. That's tightly coupled storage right next to the processor, usually SSDs. That's typical. Important to note here that I am talking about Apache Kafka. That's what this course is about. Even if you never intend to operate Kafka on your own, you're just gonna go straight to a fully managed service like Confluent Cloud, it's still important that you know the basics, the kind of abstractions and tools and terms and things that Kafka is based on. If you do run Kafka, say, in Confluent Cloud, you are almost certainly never going to think about anything like a broker. In a modern cloud-native serverless implementation like Confluent Cloud, brokers are kind of abstracted away. It's stuff happening behind the curtains, and you're just thinking about topics and messages and connectors and all the stuff that matters to you. So brokers matter when you're getting started, when you're running locally, if you're running Apache Kafka by yourself, and brokers matter just so you know how to think about this thing. Collectively, these brokers, we have a big giant cluster of three of them, they form a Kafka cluster. Each broker hosts Kafka partitions. We talked about partitions in the previous module. And in that example, our topic had three partitions. So you can see this here, they're spread out over these three brokers. Each one of the brokers has one of the partitions. This is how Kafka scales. Of course, you're probably not going to have a cluster of just one topic. So here's another one in a different color. It only has two partitions. In this case, the partitions, since there's only two of them, they're only hosted on two brokers. And topics can have different numbers of partitions depending on what you think their scale needs are going to be. Brokers are responsible for handling incoming requests to write new messages to those partitions and to read messages out of them. So those client applications on the outside there, they're writing into topics and reading from topics. And brokers are the ones that, if you will, broker those requests and do the actual I/O on the partition logs. Brokers are also responsible for managing replication, which we're going to take a look at in the next module. Now, if you are not completely brand new to Kafka and you've maybe seen a previous version of this course or read something about it, read old docs, you may have heard about a project called Apache Zookeeper that kind of sat alongside the brokers and helped maintain a consistent view of metadata. Well, bear in mind, you don't need that anymore. As of Apache Kafka 4.0, Kafka no longer includes or has the option of using Zookeeper. That consistent metadata sort of database functionality is now provided by the brokers themselves using their own implementation of the RAFT protocol that's called creatively KRaft, another thing that we named by ourselves. So as of 4.0, the brokers are storing that metadata, providing a consistent view of it for themselves using KRaft. Don't need to worry about Zookeeper anymore.